Hey there. This is an operation video for the SmartWeight HN balancer. You might also hear it called the SmartWeight Hybrid or just the Hybrid balancer. It's all the same machine. So a couple of things you're going to notice when you look at this machine. This machine does not have a touchscreen. We're going to navigate by using this knob and selecting different menu items on the screen. We'll talk about that in a second. You'll also notice that it has dataset arms. It has an inner and outer dataset arm, and this is the vast majority of what we're going to do with this machine. So let's start with that. Basically, we have a feature we call auto datasets, and the position of the dataset arms tells us what mode we want to do, clip, clip, clip tape, or tape, tape, et cetera, okay? So if I want to start off and do a clip, clip balance, so I want a clip on the inside and a clip weight on the outside, I grab both dataset arms and bring them into position. Now, if I'm not sure how to hold them against the wheel, you notice there's an animation that shows me exactly what to do. So I take the inner roller, and the small part of it goes up against the flange where the clip weight is going to go. And on the outside, the round part of the dataset arm goes against that same flange. Okay? Now all I have to do is step on the foot pedal, and those dimensions are entered. And I'm ready to do a clip-clip balance. So now let's say we want to do a clip-tape. So now I'm only going to use the inner dataset arm. And I move it into position. Again, it shows me an animation of how to do that. And I touch the foot pedal. And now to tell it I want to do a tape weight, I swing the arm down. The act of swinging it down tells it, he wants to do a tape weight for the outer plane. I move the roller into the center line of where I want the weights to go and touch the foot pedal. And you can see on the screen that I've entered clip tape dimensions, okay? So now let's say I want to do tape tape. So again, I take the dataset arm out, and because it's up, it thinks I want to do clip, but I say no, I actually want to do tape weights. So by swinging it down now, it again shows me, put the roller in the center of where the inner weights are going to go, bring it to the outer plane, put the roller where the center of the weights are will be again, okay? And now I'm ready to do tape tape. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to pull the hood down, and it's going to spin the wheel up and measure the imbalance in the wheel. I'm gonna get my weights ready. Okay, now it says it wants a half ounce of weight. And now it servos into place and stops, and it's turned on the laser line to show me exactly where this weight's gonna go. I'll get my half ounce ready. In this case, it's 2/4 ounce chiclets here. And I'm gonna place them such that they're centered right on that laser line, right where it shows me to. I'll pull the hood down again to do my check spin. And if I've done everything correctly, the screen will say okay, and we'll be finished. And there you go. So now that we've completed the balance, let's go move over to the screen, and we'll show you how to navigate. Okay, so now I put a little bit of imbalance back in the wheel so that we can show you how to navigate the menus. Now, I go back to the knob like we mentioned before, and as I turn to the right, everything moves downward, and you'll see it highlighting the different buttons. Go to the left, it goes upward. And then to select something, like in this case, I want to run a centering check because maybe I'm concerned about the centering of this wheel, I just push the knob and it selects it, okay? And in this case, I would just follow the prompts on the screen to run a centering check. Now, I can go into this tools menu, and I know it's a menu because it's got the little down arrow. And when I press that, I get a menu. And one of those things on there is a quick calibration check, which I can do to make sure that my balancer is in calibration. I can clean the threads and so on down the line. Now, if I want to return back to the main menu, I press the tools button again, and I've returned back to the main menu. I can, from the main menu, now I can launch a video player. And this might be where you're watching me right now. And I could watch a video on how to operate the machine, or whatever the case may be. I can then exit this, and I can go down and say that I want to enter spokes. So let's say in this case I've got a wheel that's a nice looking wheel, and I don't want to see, or the customer doesn't want to see the wheel weights through the spokes. So when I press enter spokes, it will have me line the laser up. It turns the laser on, first of all. It has me line it up with a spoke. I tap the foot pedal, and then it asks me to turn to the next spoke. And it has to be the next one, don't skip one. Because when I turn to the next spoke and enter the pedal again, it's going to fill in all the spokes on the wheel. Now, if I had a tape weight up against the wheel, it would split that tape weight or move it to one of those spokes, okay? So now, the next one is viewing dimensions. I can look at the dimensions of the wheel to make sure that I've entered the dimensions correctly, okay? I can change the weight mode, but generally we're not going to need that because we have the auto dataset arms, so let's skip that one. I can split the inner weights. Now let's say that I don't have these half ounce weights, or there's an obstruction, If I hit split inner weights, it's going to move those. It's going to divide it into two larger weights and move them farther away. Okay, again, it does it again. And then if I toggle it one more time, it's going to return back to the single weight solution. Okay, so that's an option for you. I can also change the language. In this case, I'm going to change to Spanish. And then I can move back to English if I wanted. Okay, and then now this last one is the servo. If the wheel is not in position to enter the tape weights, if I hit servo, it will bring that back around and turn the laser on and show me to enter the weights. Okay, so now, and at the very bottom, you'll see the SmartWeight icon. If I press that, I could disable SmartWeight. Let's say if I needed to do a static balance for an unusual truck wheel or something like that, that's available to me there as well. So basically, that's the interface of the SmartWeight Hybrid Balancer. So now that was a general overview, and now you should be ready to go ahead and balance a wheel with the SmartWeight HN Balancer. Thank you.